Have you ever wondered what our galaxy really looks like? We've lived in the Milky Way for as long as humanity's existed, yet we've never truly seen it. Not clearly. Not like this. That just changed. NASA and the European Space Agency have just released the most detailed map of our galaxy ever created. A map built not from imagination, but from real data. Over 2 billion stars, tracked, measured, brought to life. It's more than just a pretty picture. It's a cosmic milestone, and it's revealing things we've never seen before, including the Milky Way's strange shape, its violent past, and its uncertain future. We're going to explore how this map was made, what it tells us, and why it's such a big deal. But first, if you love space, cosmic mysteries, and mind-bending science, make sure to like this video and subscribe to Boundless Universe. Let's dive in. The map we're talking about exists thanks to a satellite called Gaia, a quiet little spacecraft launched by the European Space Agency back in 2013. Gaia's job? Measure the stars, all of them, and not just where they are, but how fast they're moving, how bright they are, even what they're made of. It's been orbiting the Sun at a stable point in space called L2, where it's had a front row seat to the galaxy. And for over a decade, it's been scanning the sky, star by star, gathering data more precise than anything we've ever had. To give you an idea, Gaia can measure the movement of a star down to a distance smaller than a human hair, from hundreds of miles away. Thanks to that kind of precision, we can now not only map where stars are, but trace their entire life stories. And all of this has led us to something extraordinary, because with its latest data release, we're finally seeing the Milky Way as it really is. What Gaia just gave us isn't a sketch. It's a full-scale, high-resolution map of our galaxy, built from hard data. For the first time, we can actually trace the spiral arms of the Milky Way. We can see the shape of the galaxy's central bar, the dense, glowing stretch of stars at its core. And we now know that the galaxy's disk, where most of the stars are, is warped, like a vinyl record left in the Sun. It's not flat. It's bending, twisting, moving. Even the outer halo, once thought to be just a haze of old stars, is full of structure. Stellar streams, clusters, and remnants of galaxies we once absorbed. And what's most incredible? This map isn't static. It's dynamic. Gaia's tracking motion, so we can watch the galaxy move over time. Stars don't just sit still. They swirl, drift, fall inward, and break away. We're watching a living galaxy breathe. It's like zooming out from our solar system and finally seeing the whole city we live in. And once you zoom out like that, you start noticing some very strange things. Which brings us to the part of the story no one expected. The more we look at Gaia's map, the weirder and more amazing things get. First, we found evidence of collisions. Long ago, the Milky Way smashed into a smaller galaxy called Gaia Enceladus. We now see the remnants of that collision. Entire streams of stars still looping around us like cosmic scars frozen in time. There are stellar streams, long, river-like trails of stars that used to belong to other galaxies or clusters. The Milky Way ate them, and Gaia just traced their remains. Then, there are ripples in the galactic disk, like waves on water, likely caused by gravitational disruptions from nearby galaxies like the Large Magellanic Cloud. The galaxy isn't just spinning, it's vibrating. We also found hidden star clusters, groups of stars moving together in perfect synchrony. Some are brand new, others are ancient, drifting slowly across the galactic sky. All of this points to a simple truth. The Milky Way is not calm. It's not stable. It's a galaxy shaped by chaos, built through collisions, shaken by neighbors, and still evolving. And here's the mind-blowing part. We didn't know any of this until now. This map, this release, has changed our understanding of where we live. And if this is blowing your mind even half as much as it blew ours, hit that like button and share this with someone who loves space as much as you do. It really helps Boundless Universe grow. So, how exactly did Gaia pull this off? Gaia didn't take photos in the usual way. Instead, it measured motion. Using a technique called astrometry, Gaia tracked how each star shifts ever so slightly in the sky. It paired that with photometry to measure brightness and color, and spectroscopy to detect tiny changes in light caused by movement. Each star was observed dozens of times. Over years, this created not just a picture, but a timeline. Every bit of data, over 100 terabytes, was sent back to Earth, processed by teams of scientists and supercomputers. They turned those numbers into 3D models, simulations, and maps that could finally show us what the Milky Way looks like from the outside. And guess what? Gaia's still collecting. This map isn't the final version. Every year it gets more detailed. More stars, more clarity, more motion. And with every update, we're getting closer to something bigger. Because this isn't just about mapping stars. It's about unlocking new frontiers in space science. Gaia's map is already changing the way we do astronomy. It's helping scientists model how the Milky Way evolved, where it came from, how it grew, and where it's headed next. It's refining our search for dark matter, based on how stars move through invisible gravitational fields. And it's improving how we find exoplanets, by tracking tiny wobbles in a star's movement caused by an orbiting world we can't see directly. Even the detection of gravitational waves is getting better, because Gaia helps us pinpoint where in the galaxy those ripples might come from. Best of all, Gaia is laying the groundwork for upcoming missions. NASA's Nancy Grace Roman Telescope, the Vera Rubin Observatory, and even the James Webb Space Telescope, they all benefit from Gaia's foundation. It's a map, but also a launchpad for the future of space exploration. And as we look further outward, Gaia reminds us of something powerful. We may be tiny, but we finally know where we are. It's easy to feel small in the face of a galaxy. Billions of stars, billions of years, a scale we can barely imagine. But with this new map, for the first time, we're not just guessing, we're seeing. Our home galaxy, its shape, its movement, its history, revealed with breathtaking clarity. It's not just data, it's a story. A story of collisions, creation, and cosmic time. A story we're part of, orbiting a star that's just one of billions in this vast spiral of light. And now that we finally have a map, we know where we are in the story. If you enjoyed this journey through the Milky Way, don't forget to subscribe to Boundless Universe for more videos like this one, exploring the biggest questions, the strangest mysteries, and the most fascinating discoveries in space. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next chapter of the cosmos.